Hello everyone, welcome to Easy Engineering classes. We are continuing with the preparation of various competitive computer science exams like GATE Computer Science, UGC NET Computer Science and Bank IT Officer exams. In today's lecture, we'll take up one question from algorithms subject. It was a part of GATE 2016 and it is a quite interesting question. So let's see what is given and what is asked. The question says, the given diagram shows the flowchart for a recursive function a of n. Assume that all statements except recursive calls have order of 1 time complexity. If the worst case time complexity of this function is big O of n raised to power alpha, so then the least possible value up to 2 decimal positions of alpha is, and you are then given the flowchart for the recursive function a of n. Okay, now the function is, initially there is a start, there is a node called start, then there is a recursive call to a of n by 2. That means if initially the parameter was n or the size of the problem was n, then there is a recursive call to the same problem with size n by 2, and then there is a decision node. Based on this decision node, if suppose it is true and this is false, if true is the answer for this decision node, then we'll again execute one recursive call and then return. So the case exists here. That means in this case, when the decision node answer is true or the decision comes out to be true, then the path would be followed like start a of n by 2, a of n by 2 and then return. But please remember that you have to find out the worst case time complexity, and worst case time complexity, if you can understand from this flow chart, it would occur, worst case time would occur when there are maximum number of nodes that are traversed here, or the maximum number of time is take, maximum amount of time is taken, or you can say the length of the path that is traversed in this flowchart is the maximum, and that would result in the worst case time. And therefore, analyzing that worst case scenario, the path that is followed, the calls that are made, we would get the worst case time complexity. So this was a path of length. If we count the number of nodes, start node, then this node, and then return. So 4 nodes. Now let's see if the decision was false, what would happen? There would have been another recursive call followed by a second recursive call and a decision. Suppose this was true, this was false. If the result of decision was false here, we would return. So this was a path of length 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now, if I'm counting the nodes as the length of the path, in this case, when the second decision results to be false, the length of the path would be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. So this path length is 5. Now let's assume that the decision resulted in true. So what would be done further? Another call would be made to the function A, and then there is another decision. So if this decision results, the third decision, this was the first decision node, the second decision node and the third decision node. If the third decision node results into false, it would return here. So what is the length of the path followed? We started with start. So 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5, then 6. Okay, so this path length is 6. So this is greater than the previous path. Now, what case or what would be the path length if we follow the remaining execution path of the decision node? The path length would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So this is the longest path. And analyzing this path, we would get the worst case time complexity. So how many times the recursive calls are being made in this longest path? 1, then 2, then 3, then this is the 4th one, 5th one. So basically, if I have to write the recursive function for a of n, I would be writing it as 5 of A n by 2, because the problem or the recursive call is for half the size of the initial problem, plus big O of 1. Why big O of 1? Because we are told that all the remaining statements except the recursive call take constant time. Constant time for remaining operations except the recursive call. Alright, so this is our recurrence that would result in case when the longest path is executed or the worst case is executed. Alright, now if we solve this, we would get the time complexity as something like big O of n raised to power alpha, and we have to find the value of alpha to correct to two decimal positions. So solving this recurrence using master theorem, what would be the values of a, b and f of n? Solving by master theorem. So here a is 5. The value of b is 2. This is b, this is a. And f of n is order of 1. Okay, or you can also say it to be n raised to power 0. Now let's find out the value of n raised to power log of a given base b. So this would come out to be n raised to the power log 5 base 2. All right. So the value log of 5 base 2 would approximately come out to be 2.321 something. Okay, so we can approximate this value, that of log of 5 base 2 approximates to 2.32, because we are given that this is, we have to find out the value till two decimal places. And since this is the first case of master theorem, case 1 of master theorem, because here we know that f of n is n raised to power 0, which comes out to be a constant of 1. And here the value that we have calculated for n to the power log of a base b is, oh, this value would come out to be n raised to power 2.32. Okay, so what would be the time complexity in this case? Time complexity would be n raised to power 2.32. Okay, as per the master theorem. So you need to be very clear about all the cases of master theorem, and you need to check in whether master theorem is correctly applicable in this problem. It was applicable here, and then you need to find out what is the appropriate time complexity according to the different cases that are told in the master theorem. So that is our answer for the time complexity. And here, since we only have to tell the value of alpha, this is equal to, we can write this as n raised to power alpha, where alpha is 2.32. okay, if you are asked to find the value till only one decimal position, you can write 2.3 also. Okay, so you need to keep in mind what is being asked and to what precision the answer is being is required. All right, so that's all for today's lecture. This was an easy question requiring master theorem application. So the concept of master theorem is definitely very important, because it is a quicker way of solving recurrences than substitution method or any other ways that you use. All right, so thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Easy Engineering Classes for more such tutorials in our preparation series. Subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon to get the notifications of our upcoming video, and don't forget to give the feedback of this video in the comment section below, because your feedback helps us improve the content. Thank you for watching. Good luck for your exam.